Our task for this video is very simple. We need to draw a clear distinction, a clear delineation between what is a lead and what is a drug. Selecting a lead from all the hits identified during screening is called lead selection. Or lead discovery. What properties make a good lead for a drug discovery program? This question introduces the idea of molecules being lead-like or drug-like. Let's start with drug-like. Drug-like properties can be roughly described by a group of rules called Lipinski's rules, or the rule of five. Chris Lipinski, a scientist at Pfizer, outlined four general criteria for the properties of orally available drugs in 1997. One, a drug should have a molecular weight of 500 grams per mole or less. This actually fits pretty well with our ideas of drug space, these atoms having less than or equal to 30 heavy non-hydrogen atoms. Second rule, a drug should have five or fewer hydrogen bond donors. These are OH and NH groups. Three, a drug should have 10 or fewer hydrogen bond acceptors. Those are oxygen lone pairs and nitrogens with lone pairs. Four, a drug should have a log P, which is a measure of lipophilicity, equal to or less than 5. Molecules that satisfy at least three of the four criteria will likely, no promises, be orally available. Shortly after Lipinski's rules, other scientists, notably Simon Teague at AstraZenec, promoted the idea that the properties of leads are different from drugs. Lead-like properties somewhat follow a rule of three. A lead should have a molecular weight less than or equal to about 300 grams per mole. The number of hydrogen bond donors and acceptors should be lower, at 3 and 6 respectively. The lipophilicity, log P of a lead, should be 3 or lower. So scientists have found that leads, the starting points for searching for drugs, should be different from drugs. So our goal is to design a drug. But we want to start with molecules that look like leads in order to discover a drug. Okay, this is kind of confusing. If we want to discover a drug, why wouldn't we start with molecules that look like drugs? Well, what people have found is that leads, remember, where do we get our leads? We get our leads from our hits. And a hit probably has a Ki of about 1 micromolar. That's 10 to the minus 6 molar. And we want to eventually make a drug, which is going to have a Ki of about 10 nanomolar, which is 10 to the minus 8th molar. So we need to increase the potency of our drug. Well, how are we going to do that? We're going to do that by adding molecular weight and hydrogen bond donors and acceptors. And these probably are going to increase log P. So if we want to finish here and to do this transition, we're going to add groups to make our drug, then our lead better be smaller in terms of molecular weight, smaller in terms of hydrogen bond donors and acceptors, and smaller in terms of log P. So this is why when we think of a lead, we want smaller molecules that we will grow into a full drug. So now we've clarified the difference between what a lead should look like structurally and what a drug will often look like structurally. We also introduced some terminology, things like Lipinski's rules and lipophilicity, which are common terms that you encounter when you talk to people about drug discovery.